Good morning, I'm Harley Schlanger from the LaRouche Organization with your daily update for April 15th, 2021. The last couple of days I've been talking about the real danger of war coming from a series of crises, including the developing danger around Ukraine with Russia, the terrible effects of the Caesar sanctions on Syria, and the deployment of U.S. forces in the Taiwan Strait, in the South China Sea, the confrontation that's looming there. And we've been calling on people to speak out against this, that it's not adequate to sit back and wait and see what's going to happen. In fact, it's immoral to do that. And instead, voices have to be raised if we're going to change the policy from what otherwise will lead to inevitable war. In the discussion I had with Helga Zepp LaRouche yesterday, our weekly dialogue, she opened by identifying what she described as a moral collapse of the Western system. We're looking at a plunge into a dark age, she said, and it can only be solved by addressing the whole picture, not specific cases, but looking at what caused us to get into this. Now, the aspects, some of the specifics, as I mentioned, include the events in Ukraine, where the U.S. and NATO are prodding Ukraine to confront Russia, which could escalate into a world war. The genocide in Southwest Asia associated with the Caesar sanctions, which were designed to carry out the regime change, which the ISIS and Al-Qaeda terrorists were incapable, even with U.S. support, of carrying out. And also provocations in Taiwan and the South China Sea. What Helga Zepp LaRouche said is there is a solution to these crises, but it does require a complete activation of you, of the population, beginning with the recognition that what we're facing is a moral collapse of the Western world. Now, what we've seen in the last couple of days is that voices are speaking out, even as Biden's administration is handing out sanctions like lollipops in a kindergarten. What we're seeing is that there's an important development with Biden speaking with President Putin and proposing a summit. This should be soon. It should happen immediately rather than in a couple of months. And remember, Putin called for a summit between the United States, China, the permanent five of the United Nations back in January of 2020. But it was a good sign that Biden issued this call. And it represents a potential for there to be some discussion and dialogue towards solution. Now, some of the other voices speaking out, I'll just mention a few of them. Tulsi Gabbard, the former presidential candidate, former congresswoman, a veteran, served several terms of duty in Iraq. She went on Tucker Carlson the other day to talk about the danger of a war with Russia. And she asked, are we, the American people, willing to go to war with Russia on behalf of Ukraine? And then she added that this is a war that is not a game in which there are no winners. If we continue down this path, that is something toward nuclear war, that could happen a lot sooner than any of us think. And Tucker Carlson responded by saying, why are we not talking about this? Which is the right question. A second indication, the Steering Committee of the Veteran Intelligence Professionals for Sanity, the VIPS, which include people such as Ray McGovern, Bill Binney, the whistleblower from the National Security Agency, a number of very important ex-intelligence people who are real patriots, they drafted a memo to President Biden calling for him to take immediate diplomatic action to forestall, quote, the growing risk of war between Ukraine and Russia. Among the points they made were that Biden must make clear to Ukraine that if Ukraine continues to push, that is, if Zelensky cannot restrain the Ukrainian war hawks who are looking for a fight with Russia in the expectation they can bring NATO in to back them, that Biden must make clear that if that happens, there will be no assistance from the U.S. or NATO. That is, he must restrain the war hawks. It was Zelensky's March 24th decree that Crimea is part of Ukraine and that they'll take it back, along with other measures taken from the Ukrainian side, which led to the Russians massing troops on the border of Ukraine. Now, the VIPs also said what's necessary is to engage in real diplomatic talks with the Russians. So again, you have this prominent group of activists with backgrounds in military and intelligence joining with Helga Zepp LaRouche calling for an extension of diplomacy. One of the statements I found most interesting was the former top aide to General Colin Powell, both when he was chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff and then as Secretary of State, Colonel Lawrence Wilkerson. Wilkerson did an interview in which he identified the push for war as coming from what he called a predatory crony capitalist state in league with a national security state that finds its raison d'etre in making war. Very clear what he said. He added that ignorance and stupidity are driving this, and he described our policies as strategically inept. He referred to Pompeo as a thug, and he blasted Blinken's escalation of sanctions as extremely dangerous. Another prominent military strategist, Professor Lyle Goldstein, who's an associate professor at the Naval War College, called for a strategic readjustment in U.S. military policy. Goldstein is an expert on the Indochina theater. He said, or Indo-Pacific, he said that a confrontation in that region with China would put us in grave jeopardy. He said we would lose a conventional war and would have to choose very quickly whether we would escalate to nuclear war. And he said this comes from the U.S. unipolar mindset, which believes that if China does well, that's a threat to the United States, the so-called Thucydides trap, that in order to avoid being overtaken by China, we must be prepared to go to war with China. He's denouncing that. He said this is immature, juvenile, totally inappropriate in the nuclear age. So these are some of the voices that have come out that we need more. And again, we need your support to push political figures, to push military leaders, religious leaders, to address these grave threats that are a danger to us all. Now, in terms of the support for the call for a Biden-Putin summit, just a couple worth noting. One is a former Deputy Secretary General of NATO, Rose Guttemuller. She described it as an excellent sign. Now, this, of course, is while the current General Secretary of NATO is calling for guarantee of support to Ukraine if there is a war, though stopping short of agreeing to Zelensky's push for Ukraine to be brought into NATO. Also welcoming the Biden-Putin summit, Putin spokesman Dmitry Peskov, very businesslike, but said this is something that should and must happen. And the deputy speaker of the Russian parliament, the Federation Council, Konstantin Kosachev, who said that this is something which is quite significant and it should take up a whole range of strategic issues. Now, in concluding the discussion I had with Helga Zepp LaRouche yesterday, she issued an impassioned call for lifting the Caesar sanctions against Syria immediately. And she referred to the statement by the papal nuncio, Cardinal Zanari, who called for the world to come to the aid of the Syrian people. Here's where you see the hypocrisy of the unipolar world. And there's a video of Blinken looking into the camera and talking about his great concern for the Syrian people, especially the children of Syria. And he says, when I look at pictures of them, I see my own children. And we must act for humanitarian purposes. He supports the sanctions against Syria that are holding back food, medical supplies, necessary equipment that have plunged 90% of the Syrian people below the poverty level and put millions of children in Syria in a situation of food insecurity, of hunger, of danger of starvation. And he's saying that these sanctions are humanitarian. This is where you see the absolute insanity of leading sectors of the U.S. foreign policy establishment, especially those connected to groups such as the Atlantic Council, the Council on Foreign Relations, the Jamestown Foundation, the Center for New American Security, and so on. What can counter that? A rising up of the people. You becoming informed, becoming a voice for sanity, joining the voices that are coming out, backing up what Mrs. LaRouche is saying. And I would urge you to do that as soon as possible, not in the coming months, but today. Go to our website, arm yourselves with the facts, with the truth about these crises, and join us in insisting that this situation be turned around immediately. Now, tomorrow is Friday. I'll be taking your questions. Send them to me at harleysch@gmail.com. And until then, I'll see you.